Welcome back to Temple of Elemental Evil. Start doing stuff, not, you know, just going through intros and, yeah, pretty much completely just skipping talking about how the game works and blah blah blah, because, again, this is Dungeons & Dragons. It's not exactly a simple game. There's pretty much rules for everything. But we do want to talk to Brother Smith a little bit more, because I'm looking for something different. Meddling with everyone's affairs. This is meant to be as a replacement to doing all of the, they're usually called FedEx quests, where you go to one person in the town, talk to them, maybe get something or get a message or something, and deliver it to somebody else. And that's all you do. This is trying to replace them. And, yeah, for some reason, Lily is looking for prostitutes, I guess, even though she's a paladin. Anyway. I'm sure I'll find out sooner or later. Would-be village druid who spends his days hammering on an empty anvil. If you look really closely, he's not actually at the anvil when he's hammering. Yes. Talk to Captain Renton. Again, that is all just to open up the way to do, you know, something a little bit more action-oriented. Not doing that yet, mostly because I would like to, you know, that guy's stock to refill, and I still need to talk to this guy, correct?
Okay.
Kenter Nevitz? Nevitz Kenter? Something like that? Have I done this? I don't know. I mistook the first part like 6 times. So, it is what it is.
Welcome to our fair town, stranger.
Ah, so I haven't...
You here on business or pleasure?
...talked to you yet. I'm here on a...
The name is Nevitz. Kenter Nevitz. I am the town elder here, and this complex serves as the town's defense. At least until Bernie and Rufus get that castle built. If I can direct you anywhere in town, just let me know.
Shush, I'm trying to speak. Bernie and Rufus are, like, level 8-ish characters, and they're building a castle in town. And they're not really epic adventures, but I suppose by that time, you would have a fair amount of money if you weren't spending it on, you know, things, like I'm going to.
Ah, so you have finally come. I've been asking for help now for some time. I can only hope it's not too late.
It is.
I sense chaotic forces brewing at the moat house again. After all we have done to bring law to the land, I hope this is not a sign of return to times of chaos.
Times of chaos?
Years ago, chaotic evil convened nearby at the Temple of Elemental Evil. Although largely destroyed during the Battle of Emerdy Meadows and the ensuing razing of the temple, portions were just sealed off, imprisoning anything that remained.
Instead of why wasn't it completely wiped out, my question would be, so why did you guys half-ass it? Why didn't you, you know, finish the job?
It was powerful and many lives had been lost. Besides, we all thought it was over. But the chaotic storms endured earlier have returned. It snowed just 2 days ago. It never snows in Hamlet. The moat house was at the vanguard of their operations before.
Oh no, not snow. I mean, there's no snow left, so it must not have been that much. I guess I could understand them freaking out if they got a lot. But a little bit would just be... Okay, stomach, calm down. Would just be like, oh, okay.
Exactly. If you could go check out the moat house and see what is going on there, it would be a great service to us in Hamlet. Here, I'll mark it on your map for you.
Although I suppose, you know, being a primitive people, that kind of thing would freak you out not knowing how weather works. Kind of. At least, you know, as far as most people understand it. We could go immediately to the moat house, but that would result in the same thing of me trying to hunt down a giant head. Probably going squish. I could survive quite a few things over at the moat house. Let's not do that yet. That is not something I wish to do at the current time. Let's see, what should I do? Well, I suppose go back to the entrance of town and start getting, you know, various quests. I should actually go to the inn/tavern should be the first thing I do. But mostly because, come on, guys. For one thing, there's something that I need to do there for, you know, ignore it. It's just a minor little quest that takes like 5 minutes to do. The other reason is the spells that my characters currently have prepared are the wrong ones. In Dungeons and Dragons, spellcasters usually have to rest for 8 hours or jump through some sort of other hoops to prepare their spells, to change them. My sorceress, who, you know, limited pool of spells, but can cast any combination, all she needs to do is, you know, sleep. You know, have a good 7-8 hours of rest, and she's fine. The wizard has to prepare, and other people, like the priests, have to pray, and usually, you know, if you're doing this pencil and paper,
okay,
you go, oh, we're gonna rest, and then it's like, oh, blam, there's done, and that guy cast mage armor for some reason. Why would you do that? Anyways, Lily, could you please talk to the innkeeper?
Welcome to the Inn of the Welcome Wench, madam. I am Ostler Gandigoot. How may I help you?
His name is fantastic.
Be you seeking a room now, lass?
Yes, actually. Long-term lodging.
I see. Well, now, I have a little problem that needs taking care of, and I need someone new in town to do it. Are you interested in getting the room for free?
Long-term lodging, because we are going to be in Hamlet. Hamlet? No. Well, Hamlet is a hamlet, but that's beside the point. We are going to be here for a while, so long-term lodging is a good idea.
I suspect that a certain gentleman named Furnock is cheating at games of chance here in the inn.
You haven't been able to catch him?
He doesn't cheat anyone here in town. He only seems to win big when playing with our guests who are passing through.
Yes.
I need someone new. Someone that he will think is an easy mark. Then you can catch him in the act. Come back and let me know, and you can have a free room here.
Yes.
Thank you. Let me know when you catch him.
This has the potential for you to lose a lot of money. At level 1 is not really such a big deal. I mean, I have a lot of it to begin with. What we need for this is someone with a very high spot modifier. Lily has 3. -1. 6. 8. So, Persiany. Always seems to be the druid, too. I don't know, every time I make a druid, the druid is always the one who ends up doing this.
Greetings, ma'am. What may I do for you?
He has a voice, so he's important.
I like to play a game now and again. I have some cards to play Thirdian Gambit, or some dice for Knucklebones.
He looks around as if to see who might be listening. Yeah, he's, obviously thinking, oh, someone from out of town, someone that I could, potentially get some money off of. Yeah. Never mind for now.
Ah, well. Maybe an... What would you like to know, kind
of... Yeah, he's also looking for an adventure. You can recruit Mr. Furnock here. However, it's much better if you catch him cheating first.
I like to play a game now and again.
Because I believe that if you hire him, he costs gold like Elmo does. But if you catch him cheating, then recruit him, you don't have to pay for it, which is pretty fantastic. Let's play some... let's play some cards.
Ferdian Gambit it is. The bet is 10 gold.
Okay.
A nice game, madam.
Nah, I lost.
Would you like to play again?
Please.
Ferdian Gambit it is. A nice game, madam.
Haven't noticed yet.
Would you like to play again? Ferdian... A nice game. Would you like to play again?
I don't think so, Furnock. These cards are nicked.
Why? Look at that.
Furnock, you, sir,
please don't turn
are
me
a cheater.
I just do this to earn some extra money to live on between adventures.
Sorry, Furnock. I'm going straight to Gundakota. Yes. Ostler.
Hello? Do you need anything?
Yeah, so Furnock, the... guy you wanted me to catch cheating?
Yes? What about Furnock?
Well, I caught him cheating.
That's wonderful, thank you. I will make sure he doesn't gamble with anyone here again.
Yay.
Yes. You are free to use any room upstairs at any time.
So we have a free room, which, in the course of the game will actually save you a decent amount of money. Although, in comparison to what adventurers earn, them being a very, you know, risky profession, wouldn't amount to much. It's more of a fact of the fact that I don't have to go through the...
As you wish.
You know, dialogue options. I just go up here, and that's it. Alright, let's fix my prepared spells.
Yes.
Because for one, I don't want to inflict minor wounds, endure elements and detect undead, I don't want either of those. What I do want is healing spells. Obviously, I'm level 1, I'd like not to die, thank you. What else am I going to get? Summon Monster 1, which isn't too bad. I think, though, Bless is pretty good, since, again, level 1 characters have a really bad, hard time hitting things. But why not? And get another Cure Minor Wounds. Why prepare Cure Minor Wounds? Well, simple. If someone's almost dying, and they're in the negative HP, like negative 3, every turn they lose an HP point, until negative 10, where they die. Death in D&D is kind of a pain in the butt. Cure Minor Wounds, however, will heal them 1 HP. They will, you know, in the thing before, they'll have negative 2, but they won't lose HP anymore. That, 1 HP of damage seems a lot better now, doesn't it? So he's all set. Let's get rid of Endure Elements. And I think... Actually, Produce Flame is pretty good. Detect Magic, don't need that. Let's, Yeah, why not? And you, sir? Magic Missile and Identify. Well, I don't need Identify right now. Getting another Magic... Enlarge Person could be pretty nice. How long does it last? I don't remember. I don't have the rule book in front of me. Let's just get Magic Missile. Screw it. And you don't need to prepare. 8 hours. That's it. My spells have been changed, fixed, and I have useful spells on me. The spells that I did remove. Oh, excuse me. There's Elmo, by the way. Drinking, so it's nighttime.
I will attempt it.
Where was I? What was I speaking of? About, you know, the spells that I got rid of, it isn't that they're useless. It's just right now, I'm not really worried about elemental damage or this, that, or the other thing. It's pure just physical damage usually at this point. Maybe some poison, like low-level poisons and whatnot. But usually it's nothing too dangerous. Oh, see? He doesn't ever really go to bed. And your inventory hasn't changed at all. That's fine. There's still a lot of things to do. To be honest, I haven't even, you know, scratched the surface of things I need to do in this town. Guys? Again, the pathing in this game leaves something to be desired. And there's Stumpy, bringing up the, front, rear front, something. I did talk to Brother Smith earlier, and he wants me to talk to Captain Renton, who should be down here and to the left, past this massive barn. I wish there was an option to make you guys run faster. Actually, I think there is in the mod. What would have been really nice is if the town map had the option to teleport my whole party. Because, yeah, you know, movement is supposed to take amount of time, blah blah blah, because, you know, it's supposed to emulate reality a bit. Minus, you know, the whole magic and dragons and monsters. You know, deity, like 5 billion deities actually meddling with the affairs of mortals on a regular basis. Various other things that make it... Anyway, that's beside the point. I think this is Renton's right house. Away. It should be. Villager, woman. Ah, Renton. Well met. That's a little blurred over right there. Knowledge of a situation, blah blah blah, was forceful something that I can't read. Maybe you can read it, but I can't. Did he now? Yeah, I'm out for playing the hero and stuff. No more games! Oh, it's gonna be a long one. Blah, blah, blah. Historic matters don't matter. Blah, blah, blah. Uncomfortable predicament. Blah, blah, blah. Ugh. Mathel. That's who we're murdering. Men hated him. Women hated him. Loved him. He had everything going for him, but he was a jerk face. Parents left him money, drunken, worthless guy, blah blah blah, and magic, I can see where this is going. Ancient that word, Tome, he's trying to become a lich, isn't he? I hope he screwed up, because us versus a lich, no. Oh. Thought himself to be a lich, so luckily he didn't actually become a lich, because let's face it, at this point, the party shouldn't even hear about liches. At all. Ever. It's a priest nothing less than a godly avatar. Well, I guess he's getting used, or so the story goes. Blah 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 blah. Wulkwood blog. Okay, can we leave? You know, In just a couple of minutes, this guy is saying more words than I have in this entire part. Quite clearly one of the living dead. System from Verbabonk. Blah, blah, blah. And they couldn't find him. Lovely. Not exactly be overjoyed. That's more like panicking, rioting, looting. If, you know, it was modern society, they'd probably just cower in their homes. We could destroy them at some point in the near future. I know that sounds exciting after the last two parts of just wandering around a town. Well, this part and last part. Yeah, that's fine. Mostly it's for the experience. Anything that I procure for myself, be it equipment, money, or anything else, is just bonus. I shall return with good things. Travel to Oakwood Bog immediately. No, let's not do that yet. There are still things in the town that I'd like to pick up. There is one thing that's going to end up in Lily's inventory. And oh my goodness, is it wonderful. However, getting that item is going to take quite a while. Lots and lots of subquests. This should be, well, it's nighttime. Let's Yeah. Never show this again, blah blah blah. Let's okay, morning's in 8 hours, let's just wait 10. Just stand there and twiddle your thumbs. Where are you? Mister? There he is. Yeah, woodcutter, blah blah blah. Oh, you have a... Anything about bandits? Giant spiders, blah blah blah. Yeah, I'll go kill those spiders for you. Something else for me to do. Giant spiders, again, at this point, it's something that we could legitimately do. It is kind of on the dangerous side, but, you know, level 1 characters can kill giant spiders, as long as there's not a lot of them. Oh, alright. Anything else? Oh. Hi? I seem to remember reading something about that character having quest. Maybe he just doesn't have it yet. Oh well.
Okay.
We'll worry about that later. So now I have a spider quest. Know when to fold them, that's complete. And the contact of him. So clear the moat house, which is dangerous. Welcome to Bog, which is reasonably dangerous. Which, it's challenging for level 1. But, again, we're gonna wait on that. And the masterwork items thing, which we're not even close to. So again, nothing much got done. However, you know, I'm picking up important quests, things that I need to do, and... How much experience did I get during this part? Maybe 50? I'm up to 105. Only 895 more to go to level 2. Level 2 will help immensely. So anyway, next time, more Temple of Elemental Evil. Until then.